Good day, attendees of the 2020 CGIAR Platform for Big Data Convention. And my name is Martin Kropf. I'm the Director General of the International Maize and Wheat Improvement Center of the CGIAR, CIMIT, as you all know it. CIMIT works with hundreds of partners across Africa, Asia and Latin America to sustainably increase the productivity and resilience of maize and wheat cropping systems, thus improving global food security and reducing poverty. We develop and advocate data-driven approaches to agriculture research. CIMIT is a member of the OneCGIAR and partner of the Big Data Platform, of course, and proud to be part of this first OneCGIAR-hosted convention. This year's convention focuses on digital dynamism for adaptive food systems. We need to be conscious that digital transformation affects international agriculture research in two ways. First, we have digital dynamism in international agriculture research itself for development. And then we have, secondly, the layer of digital dynamism in complex agri-food systems. In addition, let's remember that technology and digital technology alone will not create the impact. We need to ask ourselves, are the technologies socially acceptable, besides being economically feasible? Do the technologies lead to an increase or a decrease in the digital divide? Super important. And are the gender impacts or externalities? And is there also a solid science base underlying the applications? So when we have questions such as these in our research portfolios, our food systems will have more chance to be digitally dynamic. So I'm a crop modeler myself, originally. Leveraging digital dynamism to improve people's lives excites me very, very much, of course. Our opportunities are endless, especially when I compare it to 35 years ago. In many countries, farmers are using data to learn about market trends already and weather predictions. In addition, the rich analysis that big data provides can be used by NGOs, by governments, by NARS, by small companies and other decision makers in order to make sure that they can be better prepared for a crisis like now with COVID. We have made use of it already in many different ways. But many still do not have access to everything that digital solutions and big data offer, to constraints in connectivity, the cost of the devices, or awareness in general. So digital agriculture interventions allow CIMIT and partners to work faster, to scale up activities, integrate from information from different areas and gain valuable insights and develop context-specific approaches. Then you get also data back from farmers. And we are incorporating digital approaches throughout our work, making use of new sources of climate and geographic data, in developing new tools to scale up maize and wheat breeding with partners, for example, training the next generation of researchers, and working with entrepreneurs to find innovative solutions. CIMIT experts are eager to share more through their presentations in your conference. Also, opportunities for partnerships are endless. We need to work in innovative and win-win partnerships if we want innovations to reach smallholder farmers in developing countries. We need to involve smallholder farmers from the beginning. Give them incentives to participate in data sharing so that it can be used again with artificial intelligence to find solutions. This will provide the rest of the value chain with valuable data that can truly lead to dynamic digital transformation. But at the same time, let's make sure that farmers benefit from them and are protected in their privacy rights and that organizations really follow those principles. CIMIT and CGIAR are committed to making sure that information really gets to the farmers and that the data generated by farmers, researchers and others is ethically used and generates value for all. I urge you to use this event to connect and collaborate, especially with partners, but also within the CGIAR groups and partners that you may not have considered before. The pandemic has forced us to connect digitally, so opening up to the world and take advantage of that and think outside the box. So many new opportunities come up as a result of digital solutions and digital technologies. I look forward to learning from you, of course, and I wish you a successful convention, and I really look forward to hear what kind of new initiatives come out of your discussions this week. Thank you so much.